It's absolutely critical in the year 2015 that we get more computer science into our school and that all schools are participating in the Hour of Code.
I think it's really important to get computer science into schools as early as possible. When I was a kid, something simple like making a phone call relied on a touchtone telephone. That didn't involve a lot of computer science. But today, everything from making a phone call to hailing a cab is being done by software. Software is literally eating up the world.
I believe that it's important to have additional computer science and events like Hour of Code in our schools because our children are digital natives here. And so we want to make sure that our children are fully equipped to handle the demands of the new 21st century world. And so we know that the workforce is going to entail kids being hands-on and engaged with technology all the time. And it's really important that we actually start from the base and the foundation, and that starts here in the schools.
I absolutely think that students should get exposed to it earlier and earlier these days, especially given that we really don't know where technology is going in the next 20, 30 years. And computational thinking is not just about being able to use the computer. It's really about design. It's about logical reasoning. It's about critical thinking and problem-solving skills, and these are going to be absolutely essential in the economies of tomorrow.
When you think about the world that our students are going to be inheriting when they leave high school, many of them are going to be entering into professions where technology is a basic literacy. And things like computer science, things like coding, are really the best way to prepare our students for those careers, for those occupations.
I want our students to be deeply engaged in their work in a way that feels relevant to them and can prepare them to make an impact in the world.
Some specific examples where students get to apply their understanding of mathematics in classrooms of computer science are in Scratch. So students really get to work on using variables, thinking about logic, and then also thinking about coordinate grids.
E55 is a software company. So most of the people we look at or talent we try to recruit are computer science professionals. We end up using a lot of image processing, so a lot of coding in C++, in Java. We use a lot of database like for storage. So database administrators or people who can work with cloud computing are very important in my profession.
I think our school community has recognized the importance of having computer science and coding and computer-related fields as part of what our students are doing in our school, because we know it's going to be a part of what they're going to be doing in the future. We recognize the changing workforce, the kinds of skills that kids are going to be required to have as they move forward. And we are beginning to wrap our minds around what it's going to take to prepare them for the future that's waiting for them.
Oh my, to have a computer science program at our school that is going to take learning to the next level, it'd be great that we actually have more technology in our classrooms, in our schools, to have technology teachers who are actually hands-on and engaged with our kids, showing them how to develop code.
And so I think you need educators, you need students, you need families, you need community partners who really have a sense of the world that we're preparing our students to go out and go to college in and to go out and to work in. You need educators who understand the opportunity for integration within their content areas for technology. You need schools that are ready to train and prepare people to be computer science teachers.
I think there are two aspects to this, to changing the attitudes of people in STEM education. One is on the regulation or the people who set the policy, and on the other side, it's the students. So on the push side, when regulators set policy, they have to be incentivized and encouraged to understand why computer science is important. Having people like me from the industry, or in general, the industry demanding this from schools, saying if you don't have basic computer science education, you're not going to get a job, should incentivize regulators on the push side to get computer science into schools. But that's not the end of the story. Students and parents should be equally incentivized to understand why computer science is important at a very young age. And they should be, on their side, pushing regulators to incorporate this into schools.
This year, we'd like every student to participate in the Hour of Code here in Boston Public Schools, and we need your help to make this a reality. Through the month of November, we will be hosting professional development sessions for teachers at all grade levels to learn how to integrate computer science into their classroom. We also have some great prizes to give out from some of our partners, including money for schools to purchase additional technology, technology for students, and even a gift card for every teacher that participates in the Hour of Code. Our friends at Twitter, PDF Filler, and MassTLC have been very generous with donations, and we hope every school will sign up to participate in this year's Hour of Code. Thank you.
The students of Boston Public Schools need everyone's help
in preparing them for the jobs of tomorrow.
Join BPS in doing the Hour of Code this December
and help get computer science into our schools.